I'll just leave. I'm just gonna leave. Okay. Sounds good. Okay.
Late.
Bye.
Probably in the NFL. Because that's where they did a lot of their growth, was, you know, when they go in there at 220 pounds and come out at 300, you know, 4 years later. I mean, that's how a lot of it went. But you didn't really think about baseball that much until, you know, along came Canseco McGuire. Was the first time you started to hear anything about steroids in baseball. Robin Queens, what's up, bro?
Hey, Mike. Hey, you know, I think it is an unsolvable problem, and I think that TDs should be legal if they're legal for regular people in society.
See, but this is not just, wait, they're not legal for regular people. Nobody has a right to handle these drugs. They are only legal with prescription and in very small medically supervised doses. So the use of these things, like the players use them, is completely illegal.
Oh, no, that's a fair point. Let me just say one thing about it, though, and I think that the effect of steroids has been over-exaggerated.
No, you know, are you a doctor?
Well, no, but let me just say one thing. What I don't understand about it is why home runs aren't going further because of steroids. Like, I understand they're saying that steroids cause you guys to get all these home runs, and I think it played a role, but I also think there were other factors to do with the pitching nature of the baseball, and I think you've seen it shift back, not just because of steroids. But I don't understand fundamentally why the home run record for how far a ball would be hit has not changed for, you know, so many years if steroids actually make you hit a ball further.
I don't think it's the case of hitting the ball that much farther. I think it is a case of steroids making you keener in every part of what you do. So it allows you to be more aggressive. It allows you greater energy surge. It allows you quicker, fast twitch motion. It allows you incredible recovery. And remember, recovery is a very big part of this, so you can work hard day after day after day. Plus, you don't have amphetamines in baseball now, which are probably a larger reason why you're getting the fall off in production than even steroids, because I think steroids, and we could spend a lot of time with scientists about how much steroids are helping aiding a player. But if you're taking a great player and you're moving his game up 10%, you know, you're moving it up a long way. Now, I don't know how much of Bonds was steroids and how much was performance. Bonds was a top player who took it to another level. Did he take it there because of what he was taking? Did he just enhance that with another secret that he had? I mean, I don't know, because Bonds took it to a level that if, you know, if steroids could make everybody play like Bonds did, Bonds played on a level we have not seen before. He played on a level that only Babe Ruth ever played. He played a game, played a different game than we were looking at. We were looking at guys put up numbers that were different than anybody else. We were looking at him put up, they were absurd numbers. They were not normal numbers. They were numbers we've never seen before, both in terms of how pitches approached him and how he produced. I mean, he was getting so few pitches to hit, and he was hitting them soundly on such a high, you know, efficiency that it was almost mind-boggling. But he was doing things that no one else has done, so why hasn't steroids, if it just can universally make people better, why hasn't it allowed other people to approach Bonds' level? So I think all it does is take you up percentage. And with Bonds, he was starting with a very high percentage, and he took it that rest of the way. If you go into, like, two, three, and especially four. Four is insane. In 2004, Barry Bonds had 373 official at-bats. 373. Why? Because he had 232 walks. Now, 100 is a tremendous number. He had 232 walks on the season. Okay? On that season, he had 120 intentional passes. Think about that. If a guy walks 10 times, early in his career, Barry Bonds had years where he walked, you know, 10 times, intentionally 15 times. He walked intentional based on balls 120 times in 232. Think about that. That year, in 373 at-bats, he had 130 runs scored, 27 doubles, and 45 home runs. He had 45 home runs in 370 at-bats. He's playing a game, okay? His on-base percentage was 6. Well, fourth grade was 609. Getting on base 6 out of 10. 4 is superstar level. He's getting on 6 out of 10. And his slugging was 812. So his OPS, where 1,000 is terrific. We're raving about Miguel Cabrera's year this year, okay? Raving about it. His story.